Welcome to Megapath Presents. I'm Ronnie Hayes, and today let's talk about the ongoing controversy, maybe kind of sort of, about Rick Grimes leaving The Walking Dead in Season 9. Now, we got a couple different things to discuss. I want to try to get through this quick because, again, there is no real official announcement. However, more and more people are dropping hints, and it is looking more and more like this is going to be confirmed. I will say right off the bat, AMC is silent now. However, they cannot be silent for long because Comic-Con conventions are starting up. As a matter of fact, we do know they must make an announcement by San Diego Comic-Con, which is in July. So, a month and a half, I you know, I'm guessing they need to make the announcement definitely by then, or maybe even then, which seems like a long time because the fan outrage, I'm even surprised. The fan outrage is through the roof, you know, which is a shame in a way. I understand. I'm a bit mixed too as well. I'm lost, you know, irritated as a fan, as a viewer, as a comic book fan. I just don't understand this decision. I just don't get it. I feel like something's missing, like something behind the scenes. I'd feel less like that if he was going to complete the season and then that was it. But if they're saying he's only going to be in a few episodes in the first half and that is it, and yet I just don't get it. I flat out don't understand that. Story-wise, I mean, I just don't get it. And all the interviews with him talking about, you know, he'd want to do this role for a few more years, hinting that, and that was only like an interview that's a year old. But anyway, I just want to show you guys this website, FanFest. I don't know where they're getting their information, but they claim that AMC will be making a proper announcement very soon. Now, I don't know if they're just guessing. They didn't cite any sources. They didn't say any anonymous sources told them anything. Up here, they do say Andrew Lincoln will be leaving the hit show The Walking Dead after its 9th season. Anonymous sources have confirmed to us. So again, we don't know if they're just pulling from Collider or other people, or if they checked in with their own sources. Anyway, so that's the FanFest claiming AMC will make an announcement very soon. Like I said, I think that's a good prediction because they have to say something before the conventions start, or else they're going to get slammed with those questions, that question over and over until someone answers it. This is pretty neat. This is the Walking Dead Season 9 crew hat. Someone sent this to me. I don't even know what it's from. I guess someone posted it on Instagram or something. But it says, "Welcome to Season 9. Here's to a great year ahead and a new beginning," in quotations. And it says Angela Kang. She's the new showrunner. And obviously this confirms we're getting the time jump and the new beginning. So this is pretty cool. I like how they give out the crew hats and pins and stuff like this. Now, fans are going nuts because Norman Reedus posted this of an image with him and Andrew Lincoln, Daryl and Rick, and black and white, sad image, kind of portraying how he feels with a heart here. And then fans were going nuts because this is kind of like a confirmation that he is leaving the show, kind of like Norman was. We know Norman, he's like a teddy bear, he's an emotional guy, so maybe he was in a bit of a mood. And he just posted that up. I mean, that's got to be kind of a heavy, you know, burden on his shoulders in a way, because I know him getting offered the leading role is a come up, but that's a lot of pressure. That's a ton of pressure. Not only that, it's a sticky spot to be in because you're gonna get a lot of hate, because in a way, a lot of fans are looking at this like, well, just pay Andrew any money, and that's why I say something's not right, because they're going to give. Let's say, for example, I think their contracts, their new contracts, their old contracts all the way up until Season 7, they made like shit money. They made like, what, $2 million a year, you know, a season, if that. And then I'm sure they got money from other stuff, yada, yada, yada. But with the new contracts, I think Andrew Lincoln made, I forget the numbers, but it's something like a few million, you know, or several million. Less than 10, let's say 5 or 6 or 7 even, for a whole season, for all of Season 8. And then they're going to turn around and offer three times as much to Norman Reedus to stay. So a lot of fans are hearing these numbers. We don't know for a fact, and some fans are acting out, lashing out a little bit based on that. I'm going to wait and see what the deal is. I'm hoping this information comes out sooner rather than later. We do know in 10 years, you know, somebody will spill the beans and will finally know what caused Rick fucking Grimes to leave The Walking Dead early. You know, it's just madness. So here's our most prominent proof, I guess, the most recent proof. This guy here is a photographer on a set of The Walking Dead, and I believe he has directed a few episodes in season 5 and then in season 7, I believe. And he's also a co-producer and a director on Fear the Walking Dead. And he said, here's an image with him and Andrew Lincoln. And he said, many of us have spent the last 8 years of our lives living, working, creating, high-giving, hugging. Maybe he meant high-fiving. hugging and sometimes even bleeding real blood with Andy. All to make something special. He is one of the greatest men I have ever met and a friend. The show will miss him as much as you. It will be different, but it will still be great. All of us who love making The Walking Dead keep creating our asses off and sometimes even bleed for you. So this is, this would not be a smart troll or a smart promotional thing to do. Like, AMC would be nuts if they thought this was a good way to promote the show. The best way to promote the show in a scandalous way was to do something crazy that let fans think something nuts is coming, but not give them the wrong expectations, but don't give them a negative controversy, because you're going to have a lot of fans hear this and they're not as active, they don't follow up on it, and they just assume, you know, Rick's gone, I might check it out, but I'm not going to invest much time. Some fans might even just wait and binge it, thinking that, you know, this is the last season for Rick. What's even the point? We're seeing a lot of comments, and that's one thing I do want to finish up discussing. The fan outrage is massive. Every post, it doesn't matter if it's in this video, the video before this, or the video before that, every post pertaining to this topic on this channel, on other channels, on social media accounts, everywhere that have to do with The Walking Dead, it is like 90%. I'm done if, you know, Rick Grimes is not on the show. I mean, this is it for me. That's it, and yada, yada, yada. And again, in a way, I have said it from the gate. If you kill off a character like Rick Grimes too early, it affects the story in a way where that's probably the only thing you can do to get me to stop watching The Walking Dead is to kill off Rick Grimes when it doesn't fit the story. So obviously, we're going to see how they do it. And I will definitely continue, obviously, because sheer curiosity to see where they go. But not only that, to see if they have some magic up their sleeves where they can keep the story intact and keep our interest intact when there's such a hole missing. And I do feel bad for the rest of the cast, especially with so many fans acting like, the whole show is Rick Grimes. If he's gone, you know, I don't care about any of the rest of the cast. And I know we don't mean it like that. It's how it affects the story as a whole. I mean, that is a gut punch. That it's like shredding the story in such a negative way. It's like killing, you know, Shane in the CDC. If you look at his storyline, it's perfect the way it is. But imagine blowing Shane up in the CDC. Like, if he tried to put the moves on Lori and that's when the explosion was happening and she ended up locking him in a room and he's looking at her through glass and he's like, bitch, really? You're gonna leave me in here? And she leaves. Like, that'd be like an epic death still. She leaves him to die and blow up. That'd be pretty friggin', you know, badass now that I think about it. But still, that is shit. That's shit compared to the rest of Shane's story. In a way, it destroys everything that was coming up afterwards with his story and the interactions with Lori and Rick and the rest of the group. I mean, such a huge, massive hole would be missing if Shane was killed off early. Same thing with Rick, but bigger. I mean, this is huge. This is so big if you take Rick out of this. I mean, it's like killing Iron Man in a way, you know, or what, Thor, killing off Iron Man or Thor right in the middle of an Avengers story. It's like, what, really? Anyhow, or maybe that is definitely a lot different. So forget I even said that because that would disrupt the story, but you still are connected to a lot of the other superheroes, heroes, and it probably is a dumb analogy for me to bring up. Anyway, so yeah, we went over the Daryl's Instagram and this post and the fan outrage, and that's pretty much it. I want to keep it simple because, yeah, just in case AMC comes out with a statement soon, I would like to cover that and not beat this story to death, because I'm still the same as when I first heard it. Something is just off. Something doesn't make sense. Something just isn't right. This isn't like, you know, okay, we're wrapping up the storyline. It's a big one to wrap up. This is more like some shit hit the fan behind the scenes, and we got to do damage control. And I still feel at this time like shit hit the fan in season 7 or 8. And they knew about this a year, maybe a year plus. And Carl was killed off because, and I don't mean to sound brutal here, but I'm just going to say it, Carl would be expected to take the legacy of the Grimes legacy, but AMC was not confident in Chandler Riggs being a young actor, still being inconsistent with his performances. They were not, you know, ready to have him take the mantle, and in their eyes, it was better off to just get rid of that, trim the fat, so to speak, get rid of Carl, because he would be a problem in the future, because they don't want him being the legacy. They want their fan favorite, the legacy, because that's the one who, you know, he sells the most merchandise. He has the biggest fan base once Rick leaves. And they want to put all their stock into that one coming up. And it does feel like damage control, you know, paying Norman a shit ton of money when AMC historically has been greedy as shit with their money. So it just, this doesn't make any damn sense. And I can't wait for 10 years to go by and for us to find out some shit went on behind the scenes. People were not happy. Contracts fell through. Things were said that couldn't be unsaid, and it caused Carl to get killed off, Rick to leave, Maggie to leave, and the world of The Walking Dead TV universe to absolutely fall apart. I'm hoping they can pick up the pieces, and I do mean this. I really do hope they pick up the pieces, and the remaining cast and crew does something out frickin' standing that really pulls a lot of the viewers back in. I still stand by what I said. I think it should end with Rick Grimes, and you should come back with a new season with, just like you were going to do. Daryl can be the lead. You have Michonne and whatever other characters stick around. Carol and Jesus and, you know, Aaron and everyone, Enid, whoever, Tara, have them all stick around. But just start it over with that and show what happens after the death of this legend. And again, I think fans would warm up to that a lot. Just that simple shit. Like, okay, here's the beginning and end. Here's the Rick story. Whoop-de-whoop. We're going to continue on with the story. This is going to be, I know I called it the Walking Dead Dix. We're playing around with title because, you know, Dixon, Dix. We're going to call it Dirty Dix for now. That's the code name for what's coming up with Daryl Dixon in the lead. Dirty Dix. All right. Thoughts and opinions down in that comment box of everything going on. I'm done talking. It's your turn.